Students, welcome back to Sharda Maths channel. Now in this is the continuation video of the Eamcet coaching classes, and this is a very, very important video for the students. In this video I am posting the AP Eamcet 2021 complex numbers bits with solutions. Already nenu complex numbers classes naithe post chestunnanu kada, within 1 or 2 videos the topic will be completed in the channel. Okka 2 videos the topic aithe finish ayipothundi. Now I am posting the 2020 papers anni teesi andulo nunchi complex numbers lo ichina bits anni kuda teesi aa bits anniki solutions nenu ikkada post chestunnanu. Every paper loni from the complex numbers prathi paper lo 2 bits vasthe from the topic complex numbers. Okay, avanni kuda nenu ikkada teesi solutions aithe post chestunnanu. Okka sari meer aa videos nannitini సాల్వ్ చేసిన తర్వాత ఆ వీడియోస్ అన్నీ చూసిన తర్వాత మీ నాలెడ్జ్ ఒకసారి చెక్ చేసుకోండి. ఇప్పుడైతే నేను 2021 బిట్స్ అయితే షేర్ చేస్తున్నాను. సో ఈ బిట్స్ ఎలా ఉన్నాయి, 2022 బిట్స్ కూడా సేమ్ అలానే ఉండే ఛాన్సెస్ అయితే ఉన్నాయి. ఓకే ఓకే, లెట్ స్టార్ట్ ద క్లాస్. ద ఫస్ట్ ప్రాబ్లమ్, సైన్ టీటా మైనస్ ఐ కాస్ టీటా హోల్ క్యూబ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు, వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ ఆన్సర్? ఓకే, ద క్వశ్చన్ ఈస్ సైన్ టీటా మైనస్ ఐ కాస్ టీటా హోల్ క్యూబ్. సో ఫస్ట్ ఐ టేక్ ద ఎక్స్పాన్షన్ టు దిస్ వన్ హియర్. So first I take the expansion here. So this is sin theta minus I cos theta whole cube. A minus B whole cube. A cube sin cube theta minus 3A square B. 3 sin square theta into I cos theta plus 3AB square plus 3 sin theta into B square means I square cos square theta. I square cos square theta is equals to minus cos theta minus B cube minus I cube. I cube is equal to minus I into cos cube theta. Okay, this is the expansion. First I take the A minus B whole cube expansion here. A cube minus 3A square B plus 3AB square minus B cube. I cube value is equal to minus and I square is equals to minus 1. Next I take the real part here and writing the imaginary part by taking the I common here, and again take the sin theta common here and cos theta common here. Okay, and this is equals to sin theta into sin square theta into, just I am taking that this cos square theta as the 1 minus sin square theta. Okay, and plus I cos theta into cos square theta into cos square theta minus 3 into, again I take this sin square theta as the 1 minus cos square theta. Since once check the options here, in all the options we have the answers as cos 3 theta sin 3 theta. To form the terms here, I am taking the changes like this, and this is sin theta into, so this is sin square theta minus 3 minus of minus plus 3 sin square theta. Okay, plus I cos theta into, this is equals to cos square theta minus 3 minus of minus plus 3 cos square theta is equals to, so this is sin theta into, this value is equal to 3 sin square 3 into sin square theta plus 3 sin square theta plus sin square theta, 4 sin square theta minus 3. Okay, multiplying the values here, so this becomes 4 sin cube theta minus 3 sin theta. Okay, and plus here plus I cos theta into, this is cos 3 cos square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 4 cos square theta minus 3 plus I into, this is 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. Okay, and this is equals to, so this is nothing but minus of sin 3 theta, minus of 3 sin theta minus 4 sin cube theta, that is minus sin 3 theta plus this is 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta is equal to, this is the formula for the cos 3 theta. So this is the answer, cos 3 theta I cos 3 theta minus sin 3 theta, but the options are not given like that. This option is not given here, so means here we have to take the simplification also to this one. So for that reason, just I am taking this minus 1 as the I square, I square into sin 3 theta plus I cos 3 theta, and again I am taking that I common here from these two terms, so this becomes I into cos 3 theta plus I sin 3 theta. Okay, but so this is the answer, I into cos 3 theta plus I sin 3 theta. Now once check the last option here, minus I cube is equals to minus I whole cube is equals to minus I cube, minus of I cube value is equals to minus I, minus of minus plus I. So this answer is nothing but the value of the minus I cube is equal to I here. So this option value is nothing but I into cos 3 theta plus I sin 3 theta, which is nothing but the answer of this one, I into cos 3 theta plus I sin 3 theta, that is nothing but the last option. Okay, that's all, this is the answer. Now see the next question. What is the real part of the cos 4 plus I sin 4 plus 1 power 2020? Okay, this is a given question. We want the real part of this expression. So first I am taking the expression here. First I am taking the 1 plus cos 4 values. 1 plus cos 4 plus I sin 4 power 2020. Okay, this is a given question, is equals to. Now first I take that this is equals to, this is in the form of the 1 plus cos theta. What is the formula for the 1 plus cos theta? 2 cos square theta by 2, that is 2 cos square 4 by 2. Okay, plus I into this is 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2, that is 2 sin 4 by 2 cos 4 by 2. Just I am applying the trigonometry formula set to the given expression like that. Now this is equals to, so this is 2 cos square 2, 2 cos square 2 plus I into 2 sin 2 cos 2, I into 2 sin 2 cos 2 power 2020. Now I am taking the common terms common here, so this is equals to 2 cos 2 into 2 cos 2 into this is cos 2 plus I sin 2 power 2020. Okay, and this is equals to, just separating the power to all the terms here, 2 power 2020 into cos 2 power 2020, cos 4 2020 into 2 into this is cos 2 plus I sin 2 power 2020. But what is the given question? So this is equals to, now applying the de Moivre theorem here to this one, so this becomes, this is equals to 2 power 2020 into cos 4 2020 into 2 into cos 2 into 2020 is equals to 40 plus I sin 2 into 2020 is equal to sin 40. Okay, what is the given question? Real part of this expression. So real part is nothing but 2 power 2020 cos 4 2020 2 into cos 40. That is nothing but the second option. Okay, this is the second option. See, here the question is not the complete answer simplification of this step. We want only the real part. Real part means this value into the real part. Okay, that's all. Okay, see the next one. If modulus of z minus 2 is equal to modulus of z minus 1, where z is a complex number, then the locus of z is a straight line. So what is that? That is parallel to x-axis or parallel to y-axis or parallel to y is equal to x-axis, parallel to y is equal to minus x. So this is given. The given condition is here mod z minus 2 is equal to mod z minus 1. Now taking the z is equal to x plus iy here, z is equal to x plus iy, modulus of x plus iy minus 2 is equal to modulus of x plus iy minus 1. Okay. That is, this is mod x minus 2 plus iy is equals to mod x minus 1 plus iy. Now applying the, finding the modulus value, so this is equals to square root of x minus 2 whole square plus y square is equals to square root of x minus 1 whole square plus y square. Okay, now squaring on both sides and we get the value as x minus 2 whole square plus y square is equals to x minus 1 whole square plus y square. Now cut this value, now taking the simplification to the remaining value, so this is equals to x square minus 4x plus 4 is equals to x square minus 2x plus 1. Okay, now cut this value, so this becomes 4 minus 2x plus 4x is equal to 2x, 4 minus 1 is equal to 3, so the line becomes x is equal to 3 by 2. This is nothing but the line that is parallel to the y-axis. X is equals to k. X is equal to k means that is the line that is parallel to the y-axis. Very easy question, that is the question. Okay, so the next question. మీకు అన్ని క్వశ్చన్స్ అయితే టఫ్గా ఉంటాయి, కొన్ని క్వశ్చన్స్ లెంగ్దీగా ఉంటాయి, కొన్ని క్వశ్చన్స్ ఈజీగా ఉంటాయి. వన్ ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్ ద వెరీ లెంగ్దీ క్వశ్చన్. ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ చాలా లెంగ్దీగా వచ్చింది, ఇప్పుడు నేను వీడియోలో షేర్ చేసింది. సెకండ్ క్వశ్చన్ ఓకే, థర్డ్ క్వశ్చన్ ఓకే, ఫోర్త్ వన్ ఓకే, మిగిలినవన్నీ చాలా ఈజీగా వచ్చాయి. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్, ఇఫ్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఐబీ వన్ మైనస్ ఐ పవర్ ఎమ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు వన్, దెన్ ఎమ్ కెనాట్ బి ఈక్వల్స్ టు. సో ఎమ్ కెనాట్ బి ఈక్వల్స్ టు, సో దట్ ఈస్ ఫస్ట్ ఐ టేక్ ద గివెన్ కండిషన్ హియర్. సో గివెన్ కండిషన్ ఇస్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఐబీ వన్ మైనస్ ఐ పవర్ ఎమ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు వన్. But what is the value of the 1 plus I by 1 minus I? This is nothing but this is equals to 1 plus I by 1 minus I into 1 plus I by 1 plus I is equals to 1 plus I whole square by the denominator value is equals to 1 minus I square. So this is 1 plus I square plus 2 I by 1 plus 1 2. Cut these two values, this becomes 2 I by 2 equals to I. That is a simplified form of the term 1 plus I by 1 minus I is equals to I. So the given question becomes here I power m is equals to 1. I power m is equals to 1 means what will be the value of them here? M must be the multiple of the 4, then only this value returns answer is equals to 1. Okay, here we have to check which number is the multiple of 4 and which is not the multiple of 4. Okay, see the first value. So divide this number by the number 4. 4 4s are 16, 33, 4 8s are 32, 3 14, 4 3 is 12. So this is not divisible by the number 4, means this is the right answer. Now check this one also. So 4 4 is 0, 4 6 is, yes, this is divisible by 4. Now check this one. This is 4 5 is 20, 4 4 is 4 3 is, yes, this is divisible by 4. And check this one. This is equals to, this is 10 square power 50. Okay, 10 power 100 is equals to 10 square power 50. 10 square is equal to 100. So this 100 power 50 and 100 is equals to 4 into 25. 4 into 25 power 50 is equal to 4 power 50 into 25 power 50. That is 4 power 50 means this is the multiple of 4. Yes, this is also the multiple of 4. So means this is the only number, this is not the multiple of the 4. Means this is the correct answer. M cannot be the value in 1934. Okay, M is not equals to 1934. Yes, this is the right answer. This is also very easy question. Okay, so the next one, if z1 is equal to 2 plus 3i, z2 is equal to 3 plus 2i and I is equal to root minus 1, then what is the value of this expression? So, here two matrices are given, you have to find the product of the two matrices and here the elements are nothing but the complex numbers, these two complex numbers and conjugates of these two complex numbers. So, first I substitute the values in the given expression. Okay, what is the first matrix here? z1, z2 minus z2 bar, z1 bar, z1. What is z1 value? 2 plus 3i. Okay. What is z2 value? 3 plus 2i. Okay. Minus z2 bar. Minus of. What is z2 bar value? 3 minus 2i. Okay. And what is z1 bar? 2 minus 3i. Okay. This is the first matrix. Into what is the second matrix here? z1 bar. That is 2 minus 3i. Okay. Minus z2. Minus of 3 plus 2i. Okay. z2 bar. 3 minus 2i. And z1. z1 is equal to 2 plus 3i. Simply you have to take the product of these two matrices. Okay, listen. Z2 minus 3i into 2 plus 3i. That is nothing. Product of these two values is equals to a plus b into a minus b. 13. 4 plus 9. Plus 3 plus 2i into 3 minus 2i. Product of these two values is equal to 9 plus 4. 13. So first element becomes 13 plus 13 here. Now see these two. 2 plus 3i into minus of 3 plus 2i. 3 plus 2i into 2 plus 3i. Here 2 plus 3i, 3 plus 2i. 3 plus 2a, 2 plus 3a. Plus value, minus value. The two terms are cancelled here. Answer is equal to 0. 2 minus 3a, 3 minus 2a. Minus of. 2 minus 3a, 3 minus 2a. Plus of. So these two elements are same. This is plus value, this is minus value. Cut this value. Okay. Now the last one. Minus into minus plus. 3 minus 2i into 3 plus 2a is equal to 13a plus 20a minus b. Plus 2 minus 3a into 2 plus 3a. A plus 20a minus b is equal to 4 plus 9, 13. So answer is equals to 26 0 0 26, that is 26 into I. That's all, and that is the third option. Very easy question. That is the question. Next one. The radius of the circle represented by the equation 1 plus I into 1 plus 3 I into 1 plus 7 I is equal to x plus I y. So here the given equation is 1 plus I into 1 plus 3 I into 1 plus 7 I is equals to x plus I y. Now applying the modulus and both sides of this equation, so that is mod 1 plus I into, just we apply the modulus to each and every term separately here. Mod 1 plus I into mod 1 plus 7 I into mod 1 plus 3 I is equals to mod x plus I y. Okay. So this is equals to mod 1 plus I is equals to root 2. Mod 1 plus 3 I is equal to root 10. Mod 1 plus 7 I is equal to root 50 is equal to square root of x square plus y square. Now squaring on both sides and we get the value is equals to 2 into 10 into 50 is equals to x square plus y square. So the value of the x square plus y square is equals to 1000. Okay, this is the circle equation. What is the given question? What is the radius of this circle? So this is nothing but x square plus y square is equals to square root of 1000 whole square. So r is equal to square root of 1000. Square root of 1000 is equal to 10 root 10. That's all. This is the answer and that is nothing but the second option. Okay. Okay, so the next one, if z1, z2, z3 are the three non-zero complex numbers such that a is equal to mod z1, b is equal to mod z2, c is equal to mod z3. If the determinant of abc, bc, cab is equals to 0, then what is the condition? So given that here det of the expression abc, bc, cab is equal to 0. Okay, now what is the det value of this expression? This is equals to 3abc minus a cube minus b cube minus c cube. Det is equal to 0. This value is equal to 0, which implies 3abc is equals to a cube plus b cube plus c cube. Okay, 3abc is equal to a cube plus b cube plus c cube, or a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to 0. Okay, so a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to 0. And now what is the formula for this one? This is equals to a plus b plus c into a square plus b square plus c square minus cb minus bc minus ca is equal to 0. This is the formula for the a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc. Okay, but means here either the first value is equal to 0 or second value is equal to 0. That is a plus b plus c is equal to 0. But what are the values of the abc given here? A is given as the mod z1 and b is given as the mod z2. And the third one is given as the mod Z3, that is mod Z1 plus mod Z2 plus mod Z3 is equal to 0. That is the second option. That's all this answer. Very easy question. Dead easy question. Just simply finding the dead value. Already we know that the dead of this one is equal to like that. And simply applying the formula and applying the condition. That's all. Very easy. Okay, the last question of this video. If Z belongs to Z, then what is the minimum value of this expression? Already I explained this type of problem in the previous videos. Then complex numbers classes shape in the under. Same type of question and then explain JS and same type of question. Okay, see the answer. So first I take that here the given question is equal to f of Z, that is f of Z is equal to mod Z plus. So f of z is equal to mod z plus mod 2z minus 3 plus mod z minus. Okay, this is the given question. Who you want the minimum value? Okay, to get the minimum value, first of all we have to equate the each and every value of this expression to 0 and finding the z values and substituting those values in this one to get the minimum value. That is, what is the first value here? Mod z is equal to 0 means z is equal to 0. And if this is 2z minus 1, 3 is equal to 0 means the value of the z is equal to 3 by 2. And z minus 1 is equal to 0 means z is equal to 1. Okay, just equating the separate every value, each and every value to 0. Okay, separately. Then we get the value z is equal to 0 once and z is equal to 3 by 2, z is equal to. Now we have to find the values of f of 0, f of 3 by 2, f of 1, and I have to take the minimum value of these three values as the minimum value of the given expression. Okay, f of 0 is equal to substituting the 0 here, so 0 plus 2 into 0 minus 3 under modulus plus 3 plus 0 minus 1 equals to 4. The value of the f of 0 is equal to 4 here. And f of 3 by 2, substituting the second value in the expression. Okay, first value 3 by 2. 2 into 3 by 2 minus 3 is equal to 0 and 3 by 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 by 2. So 4 by 2 is equal to 2. And the last value f of 1 is equal to. F of 1 means substituting the z is equal to 1 here. 1 plus 2 minus 3, that is minus 1 under modulus becomes plus 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. That is equal to 0. Therefore, the minimum value of the given expression is minimum of these three values, that is nothing but the 2. Therefore, minimum value is equal to 3 and that is the first option. That's all. This is the answer. So, ivanni kuda meeku 2021 lo ichina complex numbers bits. So, mottam ee video lo nenu post chesina anni sums loni first sum only the first question is only the lengthy question. That is the typical question. First question okkate lengthy ga untundi. Migilina questions anni very very dead easy questions. We easily solve each and every question of this video within seconds. Chala chala chindaga unde questions. But you have to learn the subject properly, then only we will solve the questions very easily. Okay, I will continue the remaining sums in the next video. Konni questions unnayi, avini next video lo aithe share chestanu.